But on this issue, you can't find a good, convincing explanation. Is that what you mean?
No, I have to believe it.
Huh?
And no, I have to believe it.
You're supposed to believe it, this means. That's fair. The fact is that if you understand the phenomena of creation of life fully, then you have a right to discuss this subject on the question of rationality or otherwise. But if you do not understand the phenomena of the production in life and its various behaviors, how can you speak on this subject? The best you can claim, or your opponent can claim, that we don't know. All they can say, and the strongest argument in their favor, so far that I have heard, is this, that we have not come across any virgin birth in human race, so how could we believe that this was a case of a virgin birth? This is the best argument they can produce. But this argument is fallacious, because how do you know there is not a virgin birth? Because whenever a case of virgin birth was claimed, everybody disbelieved. And there was no instrument available to the people of that time to really ascertain whether the claimant was right or wrong. So the whole thing is fallacious. The very foundation of this concept that there cannot be a virgin birth is fallacious. Births without the contact without married life is so abundant that in America, as I told you earlier, 30% of children born every year are supposed to be illegitimate. Now, of those, there may be one or two, once in a blue moon, who would claim that it is a virgin birth, but nobody is going to believe. So the only one instance where Allah was a witness that this was a virgin birth, that is the instance of Jesus Christ's birth. So the best man can say is, we are incapable of judging whether virgin birth has been taking place among the human relationships or it has not been taking place. Now the evidence is coming forward from two directions, which tends us to believe that the possibility of virgin birth is not at all unscientific. As far as the reality goes, I have explained the situation. We have no knowledge. As far as the possibility goes, nobody can obviate this possibility by saying that it is impossible scientifically, because we have investigated the whole phenomena of reproduction of life in every animal species or order, and we have come to know that there is no single instance of such a case. First of all, that would be a very tall claim if a scientist makes it. The best a scientist can say is that so far we have not come across any such instance, but that is what they do not say. But I'll come to this later. The second is the possibility of any modern incident having been investigated. That has also to be explored. If in the modern age, when scientists who are better equipped to investigate such cases, if any claim was really scientifically investigated or not investigated, and what was the result? These are the two fields in which the answer to this question lies. As far as the first is concerned, there are hermaphrodites, those types of animals who have dual character. And even in human beings, one thing is positively observed, that sometimes the sex of a person is changed. What is that phenomenon? If you don't know, I will explain further, then you will understand what I mean and what relationship
homogeneous, the Homo sapien animal man, human beings, are monoception. They are single sexes. They don't have double sexes. But occasionally, we come across certain freaks of nature among human beings. And these people have dual sexes. But as long as both the sexes remain developing, they adversely affect each other, with the result that neither of the two is capable of fully developing. When the surgeons come across such a case, they ask such a person of his choice. They say, would you like to be a male or a female? Or perhaps they see and examine the case and then advise that according to our examination, your male parts have more developed and have a better chance of survival than your female parts, or vice versa. So whatever the method of decision, once the decision is taken, what happens is that doctors operate upon that person holding dual sex and removes one part and lets the other to develop freely without any competition. This is what is meant by changing of sex. Otherwise doctors cannot change sex. It's impossible. So that shows that there is a possibility of some human being having both the sexes together. Now, to imagine a possibility of both the sexes developing cannot be excluded altogether. Because in animal species we have seen such animals, and it is in fact an inheritance from the animal life. Occasionally we observe this. So scientifically, to say that it is impossible is totally wrong. No sane scientist can say it is impossible. Now I will refer to a case in the modern history which was quoted by a Indonesian paper, and it quoted originally a South American paper. I don't remember, say Abdul, he wouldn't know, because he was the person who got it from the Indonesian and had it published in Ansarullah. Where is Abdul? You ask him when he comes. I first read it in Ansarullah long ago. Ansarullah, that is the organ of the religion, Ansarullah, it published in the translation of an article. It was published first instance in some paper, some journal of South America. And then it was taken from there by some Indonesian and reproduced there in Indonesian, it's read in Indonesian, I mean. And then it was translated into Urdu. Now that is a very interesting article. And I told someone to further investigate. I wonder whether it is right or not. But Masood Jaimi sir is here? When he comes, you better tell him to find out from Sayyid Abdullahi or write directly to Melissa and Sarullah to find out in which issue that article was published. And then to write to America, to the nearest Jamaat there, to find out if they can get a copy of the original magazine in which that was published, because that's very important. Now, the article said that in one of the South American countries, a girl got pregnant who was apparently a very gentle and straightforward, honest girl. Now, on top of that, in that society, it was not at all something criminal to give birth to an illegitimate child. It had become so common that no girl would take the pain of denying or inventing stories. There's no point in it anyway. And they were given the full rights, all the illegitimate children, and this is a claim she is making, we can't believe it. But she insisted so much that they started further pursuing it and contacting other authorities, medical authorities, and to invite their attention to this case. Until this case was given so wide public publicity that some American experts also started taking interest in this case. And when the birth was ultimately given to a baby, it was a girl, all the doctors were attending. Many doctors, not all, but I mean many doctors of repute were monitoring the case, and they were ready for all sorts of investigations. Their verdict is the one to which I am referring now. It was very strange. The verdict was that we have examined the chromosomes of the daughter girl, baby, and we are surprised to find that there is not a single trace of any man's chromosome having been present here. Both the chromosomes are entirely belonging to the mother. They belong to the mother, and there is no other chromosome having been planted from outside. That is, if it was a joint effort of man and girl, then half of the chromosomes, the threads which bear characters in genes, etc., those threads, at least half of those threads, or I mean exactly half of those threads, should have belonged to the man. And they analyzed those threads which are found, and therefore chromosomes. And also analyzed the mother's threads and found out that they were exactly the same. So in that case at least, there is one evidence of a virgin birth. So everything considered, the whole question boils down to this, that man has never had an opportunity or means or capability to investigate all such cases where virgin births were claimed. And because man has been incapable, and also because if it had happened, it would have been a very rare phenomenon. So all that we can say is this, that we do not know. You can be agnostic, but you still cannot deny the fact that the Holy Quran has said something which is against logic or against scientific evidence. And further, if you investigate, I'm summing it up, then you will find that the possibilities of virgin birth are very positive, and you cannot rule them out. Even today, maybe some poor girl